बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल पीपल विल बी फाइन। सो प्लीज़ स्टे एट होम, कीप सेफ योर सेल्फ एंड लिसन टू योर ऑनलाइन लेक्चर्स और प्रैक्टिकल्स रूटीनली एंड प्लीज डू द असाइनमेंट एट टाइम। सो इंशाल्लाह व्हेन यू विल जॉइन द क्लास आफ्टर वेकेशंस आफ्टर दिस कोविड पीरियड, so if you have heard the lectures regularly, then you will know the pharmacology much better. So please keep listen to the lectures regularly. So in the practical time, I will tell you the brief history of pharmacology. Now, what is history of pharmacology? Why history of pharmacology? Science is a permanent exchange between the hypothesis and experimental facts. Recollection of the past events are the key to understand the discipline as it exists today and how it may evolve in future, what part it will play in the future. So, recollection of the past events are the key to understand the discipline. Building of knowledge onto knowledge is the science. Review of previously missed opportunities to make fundamental advances like penicillin and sulfonamide. It enables one to review his or her own research from a different perspective view. It is also rediscovery of the past. So history of pharmacology is important because of these points. As you people know, that science is a permanent exchange between hypothesis and experimental facts. Pharmacology, it's a Greek word, mean pharmakon, originally meant a magic charm for treating disease. What is the meaning of pharmakon? Mean a magic charm for treating disease. Later, pharmakon came in to mean a remedy or a drug. Primitive people uses drug for magic powers rather than their physiological effect, because the people believe that the evil spirits cause the disease. Alcohol and opium were one of the first medicinal plants. Now the ancient period. Ancient period is divided into following periods. First of all, ancient Indian pharmacology, ancient Greek pharmacology, ancient Egyptian pharmacology, ancient Chinese pharmacology, and finally the Arabian influence on the pharmacology. Now the ancient Egypt pharmacology, knowledge of the human anatomy and the natural substances around them to treat the disease. It is present in ancient Egypt pharmacology. In about 2nd century, the Egyptians collected all their knowledge in 42 secret books, of which last 6 contained medical knowledge. And ancient Egypt, their knowledge is contained in the book which is known as Abbas Papyrus. Abbas Papyrus is believed to be the oldest preserved medical document dating from 1552 BC. Abbas published it in English and in Latin in 1875. That papyrus or book is divided into 110 pages. It is written in the hieratic script. It includes 36 prescriptions, 700 magical formulas, and folk remedies. Now the ancient Indian pharmacology. In some Indian ancient, some of the people, or you can call some of the scientists which are play a role in history of pharmacology. They are Lord Brahma, Daksha, Ishibituins, Indra, and then Bharadvaja Rishi. And then finally, one of the students, which is known as Agnivesha, who is credited to be the author of the first Indian book. which is written on medicine. That is the name, the treatise on medicine. Now the Ayurveda means science of life. Ayurveda is written by two prominent physicians. First physician is Charaka Samhita, and next physician name is Sushruta Samhita. Charaka Samhita wrote the book about 1,120 illnesses. He wrote about 700 medicinal plants. He wrote about 64 preparations for mineral sources, and 57 preparations were based on animal sources. And next, Sushruta Samhita wrote about many fields of medicine, including cataract operation, laparotomy, vesical lithotomy, and diabetes. Now, the ancient Greek, the Greek god of health and father of medicine, one of the most famous scientists' name is Asclepius or Asclepius. Hippocrates is the philosopher as well as the ancient physician. He was the paragon of ancient physician. Their work of Greeks are still relevant and in use today. Now, in the history of pharmacology in Greek period, empirically they derived method for observing and classifying drugs by clinical testing. So, most famous physician, they knew mild laxatives and strong purgatives, and they formulate analgesics for headaches, antiseptics for wounds, emetics to rid one of ingested poisons. They formulate chemotherapy agents for cancer treatments and even oral contraceptives. So Greek period is very much important in the history of pharmacology. In the Greek period, about 600 plants are discovered along with some animals and mineral substances, and around 1,000 medicines made from them. Now, ancient China. What is the role of China in the history of pharmacology? Shan Deng is the founder of traditional Chinese medicine. In 200 BC, the Han Dynasty, which is regarded as the most glorious time period in Chinese medical history. Qin Gao was the first described for the treatment of fever in the Handbook of Prescriptions for Emergency Treatments by Ji Hong in the Eastern Jin Dynasty. Medieval period, it is a period of about 600 years characterized by the destruction of the... This period is very important because it was characterized by destruction of the old civilization and little progress in learning. There was a spread of Islam and Christianity in this period. Practice was a constant tradition of unstructured testing of relationships between drugs and ailments. So, in this period, progress was done. Now, the Arabian influence in the history of pharmacology. Arabs are the originator of syrups, alcohol, and aromatic water. They produced the first pharmaceutical formula or set of standards. The prominent figures like Avicenna and Geber gave a lot of contribution towards medieval pharmacology. Arabian influence, Avicenna. He wrote more than 450 documents or treatises on medicine, philosophy, logic, and astronomy. His famous book is Al-Qanun fi al-Tibb. That book is divided into five volumes on medical science, neuroscience being described in the third volume. Simple remedies were always preferable to complex drugs because they had fewer side effects. Over 300 simple and compound medicines are recorded. Geber, it is a great notable personality in the Arab chemistry, and he is a reputed discoverer of the nitric acid, sulfuric acid, and nitrohydrochloric acid. He is also called as the father of chemistry. Al-Razi, that When Al-Razi came, that period is the Islamic Golden Age. He was the chemist and physician. He classified chemicals into four categories, that is animals, vegetables, minerals, or derived substances. Books of Ibn Sina and Al-Razi taught in Europe for centuries. Now from 13th to 17th century, there was a period of progress in medical knowledge. There was a renewed interest in the ideas of the ancient Arabs, Greeks, and Romans. Most of the medical discoveries occur in this period, so it is a pavement for modern pharmacology. Paracelsus, he is a scientist, he raised the dignity of chemistry and pharmacology by emphasizing its necessity for medicine and by demonstrating the superiority of chemical medicines. Next scientist is William Withering. He played an important role in the discovery of digitalis. In 1785, published an account of the foxglove and some of its medical uses, which contained reports on clinical trials and notes on digitalis effects and toxicity. James Lind, he was a pioneer of naval hygiene in the Scottish Royal Navy. He conducted one of the first ever clinical trials. He developed the theory that citrus foods cured scurvy. Now, the first public clinical demonstration of nitrous oxide was done in 1845 for dental extraction was given by Horace Wells for tooth extraction. But unfortunately, patient cried in pain. Horace Wells became so frustrated and finally he committed suicide by cutting his femoral artery. Ethnopharmacology, it is the natural product drug discovery. Ethnopharmacology revolves around the natural product of drug discovery. Traditional Indian medicine and traditional Chinese medicine have long history and are of the great living traditions. Morphine, it is the first ever alkaloid to be isolated from any plant. It was first isolated from foxglove plant between 1803 and 1805 by Friedrich Sertner. Merck began marketing it commercially in 1827. Sertner named the substance morphine after the Greek god of dreams, Morpheus. When you examine a man with an irregular wound and that wound is inflamed, there is a concentration of heat, the lips of that wound are reddened, and that man is hot in consequence, then you must make cooling substances for him to draw the heat out. Leaves of the willow is a treatment. That are the words written in papyrus book. So, aspirin is dried from the leaves of the willow leaves and its bark, myrtle leaves, and a number of other plant extracts rely for their effect on the presence of the very simple organic acid that is salicylic acid. Felix Hoffmann managed on August 10, 1897, acetylated the phenol group and he obtained acetyl salicylic acid in a pure and stable form. Bayer was quick to register it under the name aspirin on Feb 1, 1899. Reserpine was isolated in 1952 from the dried root of raw Wolfia serpentine. Its molecular structure was elucidated in 1953 and natural configuration published in 1955 by R.B. Woodward. Artemisinin Qinghao, it's indigenous all over China and grows abundantly. Qinghao is basically the plant. That theory is made that the soak a handful of the Qinghao herb in 1 liter of water and the strained leaves to get extract, and then drink the oil extract. That is the words of the book written in Jiangsha. And another scientist extracted pure form of artemisinin and dry artemisinin in 1972. She shared the 250 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine with William C. Campbell and Satoshi Amura. Now, the cancer pharmacology, how cancer pharmacology is important in the history of pharmacology. Bari incident is that post-incident medical examiners quickly perform autopsy of dead victims and biochemical tests with hematological study of survivors. And they observed that the white blood cells were virtually vanished in their test results, bone marrow were depleted. The US government gives contract to L. Goodman and A. Gilman, Goodman and Gilman, to investigate on mustard gas. And then, gratitude alone displayed significant activity of 6-mark epinephrine and 6-thioguanine against a wide variety of rodent tumors and leukemias. Antibiotic pharmacology. Now, the role of what is the history of antibiotic pharmacology? Sir Alexander Fleming. He was a Scottish physician and microbiologist. He discovered penicillin. In 1928, Alexander Fleming was doing some experiment in his lab. He was a microbiologist. Mold called Penicillium notatum from his nasal discharge had contaminated the petri dishes of Alexander Fleming while he was doing some experiment. Careful observation under the microscope, he revealed that mold prevented the normal growth of the staphylococci. An article published by Fleming in the British Journal of Experimental Pathology in 1922, that article shows that the staphylococcus colonies became transparent and were obviously undergoing lysis. Fleming then studied the basic properties of the penicillin, including microbial specificity, its relative lack of toxicity, and its ability to produce drug resistance. For the discovery of penicillin, Alexander Fleming, Frohlich, and China were awarded the Nobel Prize in 1945. Now, the endocrine pharmacology, diabetes, ligate, pancreatic duct of dogs. Keep dogs alive till SNI degenerate, leaving islets. Try to isolate the internal structure of these to relieve the glycosuria. That were the 25 words of Banting's. And that 25 words then finally lead to the discovery of insulin in 1921. Now, write to your assignment, what is the contribution of Alexander Fleming in the history of pharmacology? Now, the receptor pharmacology, John Newport Langley credited with postulating a receptor substance in nerve stimulation. Otto Louis formulated an idea for testing the hypothesis of chemical transmission. The history of pharmacology shows how societies have changed in their approach to illness and disease form. In the Middle Ages, the growth was minimal because of religion. During the Renaissance, understanding of anatomy improved and improved understanding of pathophysiology. The mid-20th century was characterized by new biological treatments such as antibiotics, anti-cancer drugs, anti-diabetic drugs, anti-TB drugs. These are the advancements. So that's all the brief history of pharmacology. Now, please, students, submit the assignment at time, and so that your attendance will be maintained.